Hey folks, Steve Ramsden here with DIY Moviemaking, and this week I'm going to show you how to easily and cheaply light a dramatic interior nighttime scene to really add some production value if you are working on a budget. So this week I thought I'd share another lighting design, which I recently used for one of my short film projects, which I was director and DP on. I'm always telling people that the camera you use to make your film matters much less than lighting your scene properly, which will make any camera look better. So if you want to try something similar on a budget, then stick around. I'm always looking for new ways to do a lot with a little to really add some production value to my film projects, and if you want to see lots more fun DIY movie making tips and tricks, then of course hit that subscribe button. Now, how you light your scene will depend on what genre your film is, but this was a short thriller which I wanted to create a dramatic feel for. In this scene we have a conversation between two actors. Our lead actor was film and TV star Guy Henry, who you might recognise from some bigger projects than what I normally do, and our other actor was the very talented Nicholas Osmond. It's a dialogue scene where Guy's character is describing a terrifying event that he has just experienced, and Nick's character is listening and trying to get him to share all the details. So it seemed like a good excuse to create a fun, dramatic lighting design. Now, we weren't going to have a lot of time with the actors to shoot this, so after making a floor plan and storyboard, I decided that we could actually film everything the quickest if it was mostly just based around two camera setups. First, the main angle facing Guy, seated in a chair, which could change from a medium shot to a close-up by moving the camera forwards or backwards on a slider. And then secondly, the reverse angle facing Nick, who is standing, which again could become wider or tighter by sliding the camera, or at one point in the scene by moving Nick closer to the camera. We shot each setup one at a time, which meant we could light each one individually. Now, we filmed this in a private location, which was a house with a lounge and a window looking out onto a back garden, and it's actually an important plot point in the film that the curtains are open and that we can see the exterior through the window. For this reason, as the scene was set at night, we could only film when it was dark. So, for the primary angle facing Guy, we needed to find a method of lighting both the room in the foreground and the garden visible in the background. I had actually done a lighting test a few weeks before we filmed, where I had been my own stand-in, and this meant that on the day I already knew exactly what I wanted to do, and we could save a lot of time by pre-lighting the set before the actors arrived. So let's break down the lighting, and nobody is sponsoring this video, but I will add links in the description to what we were using for this shoot. For our main lighting in the room with the actors, I did this entirely by just using a set of three fairly cheap LED light panels, and that's why I think having a kit of these is so useful no matter what level you are at. It also means you can start having a go at three-point lighting when lighting actors, and then add or take away the lights depending on what you want. I got this particular kit from Niwa, but for beginners, I think really any similar set is fine, as long as the panel lights have adjustable dials for both brightness, meaning you can dim them high or low, and color temperature, meaning you can get cooler or warmer looking light. For the key light, meaning our main light on the actors, I wanted a soft glow on our main character's face, as if from a table lamp just out of shot by the window. For this, I've found if you have an LED panel with some barn doors on it, you can make a pretty good cheap softbox by just adding something as some diffusion over the front. I got this diffusion sheet from another lighting kit, but you could make your own by just using something like tracing paper. And you could even just use a household lamp for a key light, with something diffusing it. Remember, nobody will see the kit you are using off camera, so experiment with cheap lighting solutions before you spend a fortune on anything more professional. So I placed this soft key light off to the opposite side of Guy, and this meant that the camera was more on the shadowy side of the face, which I recommend for most kinds of films, as it normally looks more dramatic. Next, for a backlight, I used the second LED panel and raised this up on a stand and tilted it down. This one didn't need much diffusion and could be a bit harsher, although in the end I did add some to this light as well. This was really just to pull the character away from the background and add a nice hair light around the side of the face and the shoulder. I found I didn't actually need the third light panel in this setup, as I didn't think the scene needed a fill light, and we also had a big sound blanket nearby anyway to make the room less echoey, and this was already bouncing enough light back into the shadows. Finally, I decided that the background was a little uninteresting, so I simply shone a desk lamp up at the back wall to pick out the brickwork texture. Next, I needed to light the garden. I started by switching on two practical lamps which were on this shed, which immediately made a much more interesting background as they would be nice and blurry behind our character. Then I wanted to use something to act as moonlight to make the rest of the garden visible, but as we only had one night to shoot and I didn't know if it would rain or not, I wanted to keep this light under some cover. In the end, the best solution was to shine a light out of the upstairs window of the house, and this did a great job of illuminating the garden while also staying dry. For this, I used my Aperture C300 D Mark II light, so funnily enough, this was actually my most expensive light and it was only being used to light the background, but this was the best use for it as it was a wide area to cover and it is very bright. In fact, it only needed to be on about 30% of its full power to light the garden as moonlight perfectly well. I also aimed this light through some CTB or color temperature blue gel, which was taped to the window. This cooled the daylight color temperature of this light down even further and so made it look cooler. All the lights in the room were set on tungsten color temperature, and so I set my camera to this as well. This made the interior look warmer in contrast to the garden outside, which looked much colder thanks to that blue-looking moonlight. So, using this lighting design, we could first shoot all of the shots facing Guy. This was a mixture of wider shots, closer shots, and some moving shots where the camera tracks in or out to add emphasis for certain parts of the scene. Next, we could break and move the camera over to the reverse angle to get our shots of Nick's character. We actually cheated a bit and shuffled everything away from the wall behind him to make the room look bigger and to blur the background a little more. We kept the soft key light in a similar place near the window and just moved the backlight to the opposite side of the room so it was now behind Nick. Again, we did a little uplighting on the wall behind with the desk lamp, but it didn't need much of this as the wall on this side of the room was already brighter. With this setup, we could shoot all of Nick's shots, again moving from wider to closer as and when the intensity of the scene called for it. And then we were done, and in just a few hours we had created a really effective and dramatic scene with our lighting, to hopefully look like a big expensive production, and even though we were doing it with an incredibly low budget, we hopefully achieved something looking fun, moody and cinematic. So you can always use this lighting plan as a starting point, and just add or take away any of those lights when trying your next dramatic film project. Hopefully you found this useful, and just let me know below if you'd like to see more lighting tutorials like this for my short films. And if you want to learn how to make the best film you can right now on a budget, you can of course check out my full courses at diymoviemaking.com or via the links below. Happy movie making, and I'll see you next time.